Today is Wednesday, which brings a new update to Old School, being a rework of the Shades of Morton minigame. Now first of all, I want to say I was very happy seeing hundreds of people running around this once abandoned minigame, but this video isn't going to cover all the new content in detail. In fact, you can probably tell from the title that I'm going to showcase the loot from using 100 of the new golden keys. Now the dungeon of Shades of Morton saw a visual overhaul, making it easier for players to get into the minigames, so hopefully the minigame stays active. But we also saw a new tier of shades added, these being the Urium shades. These are level 140 combat, and they're not the toughest NPC to defeat, if you have decent stats and gear of course. But I'll go more in detail tomorrow, when I'm going to upload a loot from 1 hour of Urium shades video. This means we also got a new tier of chests to open, so I thought I'd open 100 of them to show you guys the loot. First of all, I want to address that in total I used 12 black, 6 purple, 19 brown, 19 red, and 45 crimson keys, totaling out to 101 chests being opened. The loot is fairly average, about 350k for a full inventory of mixed keys, but there are some rare items to collect from these chests. First of all, there's new prayer rope pieces, which are untradeable and give no stats, but its effect is that each piece gives a 1.25% chance to save a bone or an assault head. The full 4 set piece will boost that effect up to 5%, and this effect is stackable with the Wilderness Altar. The next two rare items you can get from these chests are the Swamp Bark and the Blood Bark recipes, which are created by using a piece of Split Bark armor on the corresponding altar with a set amount of its runes, creating the two new mage sets. The Swamp Bark armor extends binding spells by 1 tick per piece equipped, and the Blood Bark armor increases healing of all ancient blood spells for 1.5% per piece equipped. I actually managed to snag the Blood Bark recipe, later selling it for about 530k GP. Now I'm not sure if you need a recipe for each piece of armor that you want to create, so let me know down in the comment section below if you know anything about that. Now the loot from these chests is mostly adamant and rune armor, some battle staff, spears, and I even got one dragon mace, which I later sold for a measly 33k. The price check is fairly inaccurate as well, since most of these items are crashing due to the content being so popular, since I did do this on the day of release after all. Amulets of the Damned crashed down to about 50k the last time I sold one, which is kinda crazy, but the overall GP made from 101 keys was roughly around 1.5 mil with the recipe. It's also worth noting that the shade remains are tradable, so you can buy them from the GE, not having to kill the shades yourself. A few hours after the update, I bought the Urim shades for about 25k each, but since then, they have dropped to about 14k each and will probably continue to do so. Overall, I'm very happy with the update. I think it gave life to a dead minigame, but just how much life, only time will tell. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, subscribe for more content like this, and I'll see you guys tomorrow with the loot from 1 hour of Urium Shades video. Peace!